One of the main challenges that we're faced within this research or really any sort of public health focused research is being able to actually affect the public on a large scale. And right now, there are about 79 million people per year in the US who need some sort of treatment, but there are only about 700,000 mental health care professionals. Because that's about a 100-to-1 ratio, it's going to be impossible for clinicians to actually serve all of those people. What technology can do is that it can really multiply the force of mental health care treatment, because there's no marginal cost with any sort of app, and about 86% of Americans have an internet connection, and so it's relatively easy to connect them all to an actual treatment, and we could also make it no cost, or at the very least low cost, and start to have a big impact. Technology is a new path that we can take and that I feel like we must take in order to have a big impact. The suicide rate in America actually really hasn't declined appreciably since about 1900. It's actually gone up about 15% or so since the year 2000. So this is not an easy problem. There are not going to be easy fixes. But we think that technology provides a totally new kind of tool, a disruptive innovation, if you will, that can actually start to have this larger impact. But we're not there yet. We're just starting to take the first initial steps toward this. But I'm optimistic that through doing this, in a few years, we may actually start to see declines in the national suicide rate.